Hello and assalamu alaikum. I hope that each and every one of you will be doing great. So this is lecture number 13, and the end of the previous lecture I was discussing about biomass and its effects of environment and its challenges. In this part I will discuss about the idea of using biodiesel. Biodiesel burns much cleaner as compared to the other fossil fuel that are available in the market, including diesel. Biodiesel has less non-toxic and biodegradable exhausts. However, nitrogen oxide emissions from burning biodiesel is significantly higher as compared to the emissions which are made from the internal combustion engine, which is basically used for petroleum based or fossil fuel based engines. It is carbon neutral and produced from the vegetable oils or animal fats, including recycled restaurant oil and grease. The idea of using vegetable oil as fuel for diesel engine is more than 100 year old. There is a man named Rudolf Diesel who ran the diesel engine on peanut oil at World Exhibition in Paris, that was conducted in Paris in 1900. However, the availability of low-cost petroleum-based hydrocarbon fuels left no interest to the investor in the diesel which is being produced using plant oil. After, however, 1970s world oil crisis, the growing ecological awareness led to the rediscovery of biodiesel, which is basically generated from vegetable oils, to be a possible alternate to fossil fuel. However, there are considered to be several hurdles in using vegetable oils as fuel. For example, vegetable oil possesses viscosities which are 10 to 20 times higher than the viscosity of fossil fuels or fossil fuel based diesels which are currently available in market. This leads to fuel atomization to be poor, and as a result it leads to incomplete combustion. Also, extremely high flash points of vegetable oils and their tendency towards oxidation and polarization will lead to their degradation and will aggravate the situation, which will lead towards the formation of black soot formation in the injectors, nozzles and spark plugs. A gradual dilution and degradation of lubricant oil and sticking of piston ring is also a major challenge that will be faced by the engine designers. However, these problems can be solved by either adapting the engine to the new fuels or adapting the fuel to the engine. The first strategy will lead to the development of vegetable oils which are not commercially relevant today. And the later one is aimed to modify the vegetable oils by adding various additives or by using different technologies to produce fuels which have the properties that are relatively comparable to the properties of the diesel that is being produced using fossil fuels. In a research, 175 vegetable oils are blended with petroleum diesel. But this blending did not lead towards the satisfactory result. This blending is generally considered to be non-satisfactory and impractical due to high viscosity of vegetable oils and free fatty acid content. Also, the gum formation due to oxidation and polymerization of these oils. The problem of the high viscosity vegetable oils can be resolved by forming micro emulsion with solvents such as methanol, ethanol, and butanol. These are the fossil fuel based fuels, and they will reduce the viscosity of the diesel that is being produced using vegetable oil. By adding these additives, these can improve spray characteristics by explosive vaporization of low boiling constituents in the methanol, ethanol, and butanol structures. Microemulsions of aqueous methanol or ethanol in soybean oil are nearly as good as number 2 diesel in spite of lower octane number and energy content. Vegetable oils or animal fats can be converted into smaller molecule by degradation using the means of heat or catalytic conversion. The fuel obtained through this process is has a characteristic of diesel-like fuel, and it is named as diesel-like fuel also. Since there are variety of components including olefins and paraffins which are similar to the petroleum based diesel. However, the pyrolysis cat cracking process requires higher temperatures, which ranges between 573 to 773 Kelvin, and the characterization is difficult due to variety of reaction products. The equipment for thermal cracking and pyrolysis is expensive for modest efficiency. While the products are chemically similar to the petroleum-derived gasoline and the diesel which is obtained by fossil fuels, the removal of oxygen during the thermal processing also removes an environmental benefits of using an oxygenated fuel. It produces some low value materials and sometimes more gasoline than diesel fuel. The other method is alkalysis of vegetable oil. In this process, alcohol is basically mixed with vegetable oil in order to reduce its viscosity, and it is considered one of the most practical and commercial methods to produce biodiesel. This process involves a reaction between triglyceride and alcohol from biodiesel and alcohol. Different types of alcohol such as methanol, ethanol, propanol and butanol have been used by various researchers. However, methanol and ethanol are most widely used. Practical methanol, owing to its low price and availability, is the most available resource to be added to biodiesel. Fatty acids like methyl and ethyl esters, commonly referred to as biodiesel, are promising candidates as an alternative source or alternative diesel fuel. This process has been widely used to reduce high viscosity of triglycerides, which are present in plant oils. If methanol is used in the process, the method is known as methanolysis. The name biodiesel means life and diesel from redox diesel, petrodiesel. It has been given to the transesterified vegetable oil to describe its use as diesel fuel, and renewable nature also contributes to this factor, which helps to replace the fossil fuel based diesel to biodiesel. In hydro treatment, oxygen found in vegetable oils and fats are basically removed by the treatment with hydrogen. It involves deoxygenation and decarbolization, and it is mostly accompanied by cracking the molecule. It is a direct route to hydrocarbon chains of the fatty acid components of the triglycerides, and it is considered ideal and the shortest route to produce hydrocarbon based biofuel that will have the properties which are identical to the diesels which are currently available in the market. However, there are issues relating to this process that are dependent upon the economic conditions of a certain country. The process is commonly employed for obtaining deoxygenated biofuels from triglycerides includes thermal and catalytic pyrolysis, but recently hydrogenating and deoxygenating are receiving more research interest because they are cheaper technologies. Also, the other concerns are the forest that are being cleared or burned to grow the types of vegetables that can be used to produce biodiesels, including soya bean and palm trees. They make a negative impact on our environment because they destroy natural forests, which are more beneficial and help in reducing the climatic changes and greenhouse gases. This is a example of a bus that is powered by biodiesel, and its name is UC San Diego Green Line, powered by biodiesel.